Hi, I'm Chuck from ServiceNow. In part one, we looked at debug output controls. In this video, we'll look at session debugging and our best practice recommendations for debugging in Fuji. Now, let's begin by looking at session debugging, which allows you to turn screen output on or off for a specific application. This is similar to the old System Diagnostics debug log module for all applications. The related links UI action on the application form allows you to enable session debug and disable it as well. Let's set up a business rule to test variables as needed as the application runs. When enabled, gs.error, gs.warn, and gs.debug statements are visible in the session log when they occur. Now let's look at some best practices for debugging in Fuji, starting with properties. First, we recommend creating both the destination and verbosity properties for your custom app in the system properties. Here, we're creating the verbosity property for our book reviews app. Note that you only need to enter the property suffix, which in this case is logging.verbosity or logging.destination. The property name is a calculated field that concatenates the scope name with the suffix name. By using a choice list for the property type, you can avoid administrative errors when typing in the values. Set the type to choice list and enter the setting choices as comma-separated values with a label equals value format as shown here. Second, we recommend creating a properties page for your custom app's debugging properties. You can see how to do this in the ServiceNow System Properties Best Practices video. After you set this up, you can quickly find and set the property values to streamline the debugging process. Third, we also recommend setting your application's default verbosity to error and the default destination to DB. This is contrary to pre-Fuji best practice recommendations where we recommended turning off debugging, especially in production. The rationale is that you should be using GS error statements sparingly, where the errors are really occurring, not for general debugging output. That's more for GS info and GS debug. Then, if something goes wrong in production, you have a record of it without having to reproduce the error. If needed, you can change your properties and increase verbosity while you investigate further. Then you can set it back to error when you've resolved the issue. Fourth, use the new sequence field in the log list to sort entries accurately. As mentioned earlier, when your destination is DB, you can find your log messages in the application logs. However, like pre-Fuji debugging with GS log, you'll see that log messages may appear in the wrong order. Although not totally obvious here, the error statement runs first, then warning, then info. However, if you sort by creation date, the best resolution you can get is 1 second, and all three statements ran at the same time, so it's not entirely accurate. Introducing the sequence field, which includes resolution to the millisecond, much like the session debugging output. Now, when you sort, you get that extra level of resolution to put things in the proper order. Just a quick caveat here. Don't put the sequence field in the first column, as it won't display properly. Fifth, use all methods appropriately. Don't just use gs.error everywhere. Use gs.error only for critical errors. It can create a large table in the database and can obscure truly useful information. And now we'd like to share a few notes about debug overriding verbosity settings. Keep in mind that when session debugging is on, all debug statements go to the session log or screen, as we can see here. Verbosity settings are ignored. This may be helpful or annoying depending on your situation. Also, notice that all the debug messages have a prefix except gs.info debugging messages, which have no info prefix. According to our developers, this is by design. Info is assumed to be the default logging level if no other verbosity is defined. Another thing to keep in mind is that the new methods use message format parameters. Unlike previous releases, where we use a plus to concatenate the output string, we can create a GS debug statement. Instead of concatenating a lot of strings, variables, object properties, and more strings, we can create a fairly straightforward string and use curly braces around numbers that correspond to the subsequent parameters. Let's look at an example. Here, the curly brace 0 curly brace is replaced with the value of the current record sysid, and the curly brace 1 curly brace is replaced with the number. This produces output similar to this. And finally, a word about legacy apps. You will not need to convert old code in legacy apps, as gs.log and gs.print are still available in the global scope. However, we recommend you start using these new methods for both legacy and global apps, so that you don't have to remember two different APIs. There are no global properties to control destination or verbosity. This is done implicitly, as the old methods map to their new counterparts. Also, message format is supported. Well, there you have the best practices for debugging your custom applications in Fuji. For more information, please consult our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.